Hi, I'm Erica, and I love reptiles. Today, I'm at the Reptile Discovery Center at the Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute in Washington, D.C. Inside, there are so many remarkable reptiles, and they all require daily care. I'm about to take you inside to go see some of those reptiles up close and meet Kyle, an animal keeper at the zoo. You've probably heard of an animal keeper before. Maybe you think about feeding animals or even scooping poop as some of their jobs. While those are important parts of the career, there is so much more to being a keeper. Kyle even trains reptiles as part of his career. Before we meet him, there are three things I can tell you about Kyle and his career. First, he knows a lot about animal biology. Second, animal care takes great teamwork and communication. And third, training a reptile takes a lot of patience. Let's go meet Kyle to get the inside scoop on his career.
Hi, my name is Kyle Miller, and I'm an animal keeper here at the Reptile Discovery Center at the National Zoo. My job is to take care of all the reptiles and amphibians, so that's everything from the small salamanders to the biggest crocodiles in our collection and everything in between.
How do you train a reptile?
All right, so this is Rulon, one of our Aldabra tortoise. So I'm working on target training with them. I'm using a red target frisbee here. These guys tend to be attracted to bright colors. And what we do is when he touches the target, he gets his reward. So today that reward is a carrot. And the purpose of this for managing the animal is we can get them to turn or come to us or position any way we need them for medical treatments, or sometimes it's even more simple than that. We just need them out the way so we can clean. Once he targeted perfectly, we'd give him a big giant reward.
What tools do you use when training reptiles?
Okay, so we have a snake hook, and that's what we use for handling our venomous snakes. In the middle here, we have our Aldabra tortoise training target. Lastly, we have our target buoy. Buoys are a pretty standard targeting tool. They use them for not only reptiles, but other types of animals as well, from birds to marine mammals. We made a smaller version for reptiles.
What skills does a good zookeeper need to have?
So to be a good zookeeper, you need really good observation skills. Know your animals really well so that, you know, when something's off, you know how to report that to a vet in time before it gets worse. With reptiles, a good example, we make modifications to their environment all the time as we're constantly learning about their wild habitats. One thing we tried with our Grand Cayman iguanas was increasing their basking temperature, so the hottest spot in the exhibit where they can access. Through observation, we learned that a 150 degree basking spot is too hot, but a 120 degree basking spot is perfect. Definitely have to have good nerves. If you're too reactive, the animals play off that, and that can often lead to dangerous situations.
How do you work with and train venomous snakes?
When you're working with venomous snakes, one thing that's challenging to do in certain habitats or certain exhibits is when you have to lean in and pull them out. That's also a little more dangerous. So we have a scenario where we can easily just target them to us and get them into a secure container. The purpose of this is to feed them separately. So we have two animals on exhibit. False water cobras are very food motivated. So if we were to try to feed them together on exhibit, you risk them both grabbing the same prey item. Yeah, even when they don't come all the way to the bucket, just them being that close to the door is better. Reptiles don't always cooperate perfectly, but with them not coming all the way out, I can still easily hook them out from here and put them into the container, which is what I'm probably gonna do. Thank you.
what is your path to becoming a zookeeper?
So honestly, the way I got my foot in the door, in addition to my education, was volunteering. For younger kids, they have junior zookeeper programs, there's zoo camps, even at your local nature center. So if you have any of those opportunities open to you, and family or friends that can help get you there, that's the first way to get your foot in the door, is through volunteering.
What advice can you give to students who might be interested in being a keeper?
That's the biggest thing I always say, is get outside and learn as much as you can about the natural environment around you. That's what all this ties back to, or what the goal of it is to tie back to, is saving these animals out in the wild.
Thank you so much for joining as we made career connections and learned about some of the unusual parts of being an animal keeper. I loved seeing how Kyle can train reptiles to participate in their own care, and how he uses biology to provide the best care for the animals here at the zoo. You can practice being a keeper just like Kyle. Help take care of a family or class pet. Read all about it first, then look up what it might like in its habitat. Finally, keep a journal of all the things that you did to take care of the animal. I hope you liked meeting Kyle as much as I did. See you in a while, crocodile.